So I'm just tracking our results from the Valentine's Day postcard and floral prodigy. It looks like we made about $2,600, but we spent about $6,000. So I'm just wondering if that was a good investment.
I think that's a great point that Lindsay was asking about, and I think something that everyone should remember is, what is the value of marketing? It seems more often than none, people want to quit and find a reason why they shouldn't market or why it didn't work. Reason being, you don't get the best return on investment immediately, but what you plant are seeds for the future. If I had to tell anyone to skip one holiday for marketing, it would be Valentine's Day, because we're all so busy at the very end. However, you're missing an opportunity to see what the real value is, and that's to brand your business. See, in Sarasota, we had 65,000 inserts put in our Sunday newspaper. Those people saw this postcard, saw these arrangements, and more importantly, saw our name. What if we would have placed a full-page ad in the newspaper? And we know what those results are. At least with this, people ordered. We saw that we got about $2,600 worth of sales. We spent about $5,800 or about $6,000. So what do you think about that? $6,000 spent, $2,600 return. Not the best return, but how many of those people are going to order a second time? These are the questions you should be asking yourself, because to just stop doing it is an easy answer. Okay, we won't do that. That's $6,000 we saved. Now look at your overall sales for the holiday. How much were you up? Is $6,000 really even moving the needle? How much was your sales for that holiday? Because we're supposed to advertise 6 to 8%. I promise you, you'll be within those numbers. I was well within those numbers. Maybe I should have advertised more. So I got $2,600 worth of sales. I spent $6,000, and what I have are seeds that are planted. What if I didn't do this? And I open a Sunday paper, and there's everyone else advertising, meaning Telefor and FTD. Where's Beneva? Where's the local brand? This is what's missing in our industry today. If we stop overanalyzing the one-time insert, one-time advertisement, and break it out throughout the course of a year, I think our sales begin to improve, as does our brand. So, if we had to ex-nay one postcard for immediate result, it would be Valentine's Day. And let me tell you the real clincher. At the very end, so many people still came in with the postcard or were thinking about it. They couldn't use the coupon, so there was no credit given to the postcard. But people were still walking in the door buying because they saw our brand. We don't know how many customers walk in our door because they subliminally saw a television commercial. They heard you on the radio. I know flower shops are doing both, and I know they're not measuring those results. This is just one that can be measured, and it's in front of somebody, and it's in the newspaper. So, postcard, I think it's a seed that we plant, and here's the best part of it. Floral Prodigy. We have a report on there that shows you anyone that orders two or more times. What's going to be real interesting is to see how many of the customers that ordered the $2,600 worth of sales, how many of those people ordered in July and August? This is the magic of marketing, is the repeat business, sending out that preferred customer card that you can get from CompuForms or any of the local printers. We can even get them printed for you. You can print them locally yourself. John Henry makes them, anybody you can get them from. But get that second order. And this also serves as a menu. These are the items that we focused on. Production, production, production. Because the only problem we found with this was there was too many different varieties. We came out with a beautiful new brochure for Mother's Day featuring 5 flowers and 10 arrangements. So you're going to see these are very easy to mass produce. Several of these containers all have the same base, so you can set up a couple hundred, a couple dozen, whatever you need in your store, and then you can just add the centers to finish up the arrangements and complete them. So now you're mass producing nice quality, trendy arrangements and reducing your labor cost. So we're learning, we're getting smarter, but it's all starting with marketing, because this is how we build our brand. And if we want to stop the national marketers from taking our customers, we've got to stop giving them away. Thank you for listening, and I hope this helps you maybe think a little differently about your marketing strategies and your return on investment.